Welcome to the greatest internet show you've never heard of, but we are making waves in the kiddie pool.
Now everybody, have you heard?
This is Jesse Madsen. And this is his brother Sam Madsen. Together, they have created the dumbest internet show on the planet. It's literally an internet show about nothing.
Everybody's doing something. We'll do nothing.
This is a show about the obscurities of everyday life.
What return policy do you have on beached boats?
Will you come get this?
The local big time show starts right now. Aw, yeah.
How we doing? Big show.
How you doing? Big show. Bigger glasses.
Big show.
Big show. Bigger glasses. I got the full visor. I can handle danger.
These glasses are happy.
These glasses just get bigger and bigger each year.
Are you in the CHL? Because you're wearing a half shield right
now. I got the Danny Heatley visor.
You just come off the ice, because that's a pretty sick visor you got going.
Tell you what. Hey, buddy.
Where'd you get those?
Oh, I think I got them at Walmart. I don't even know. Oh, I'm not even
100%. Even better.
Even better. The heartbeat of where these should come from.
Heartbeat of America.
Walmart. Both Walmart purchases, the bandana and glasses. I just felt like you needed something to complement the glasses, and
absolutely,
what better way?
It's a Walmart purchase.
Oh my God.
Target. I should have. I'm surprised they don't have like membership cards for Walmart.
Oh, have you heard what's going to happen with Walmart Plus coming out?
Walmart Plus? What's Walmart Plus?
You've never heard of Walmart Plus, huh?
I think I know what it is. Is it
they're going to charge you for
hitting up.
Yeah, you're going to get, dude. Yeah. I just, my God, thought, like, let's just take a 5 minute thoughts and prayers for every employee who works at Walmart who's going to have to deal.
Did you hear why they were doing that?
Yeah, because everyone just steals from Walmart, and it's like the stupidest thing. Yeah.
So two things people are doing. The first thing is people are just running right out the fucking front door.
Just leaving. Do not give a shit.
A file full of shit, and they're fucking running right out the door.
And they just wave to them. They wave them out, yeah, too. It's like they can't do anything.
The other big thing is they don't, Walmart and Target, those machines aren't weighted. So people are doing like, I saw this guy, like,
they're basically clicking on whatever the fuck item they want on the thing.
Yeah, it's so like $2. Just pay for one of them. So, like, for example, trading cards is a perfect example. This guy, he had, like, 10 things of trading cards, right?
Yeah.
And he had them in his hand like this, and he scanned the one on the bottom.
Yeah.
And then put the whole stack in the fucking thing. So he had gotten, like, something like $500 worth of trading cards for like $40.
Oh yeah. But you know what's going to happen? I feel bad for that guy who's got to police the fucking self-checkout premium squad, premium lane.
Yes, but now Walmart is doing a thing where you have to pay a membership to use the self-checkout. Like, it's fucking some kind of
$65
year? Like, it's some kind of benefit to me to use the self-checkout. Like, what? Yeah. I wasn't using the self-checkout because it was faster.
Convenient.
Or was
there was just no one working the
There's
registers.
There's nobody else checking people out. You got one guy on a register and seven self-checkouts. Where you
correct me if I'm wrong. The self-checkout was to solve the not having the employee check
your
deposit.
Not having the employees to check out the money.
So now I can't get scanned and I can't use the self-checkout?
I feel like your logic, Walmart, isn't on point. Your logic isn't lined up. correctly.
Dude, the fucking tempers that are about to fly when there's one guy working the register for 1,000 people trying to check out.
I wasn't using the self-checkout for convenience.
No, I hate fucking scanning my own shit. I love when someone else puts it in the bag for me. It's so much better. Oh, I fucking hate it. Call me arrogant.
Like, Americans are some like we're the Japanese. Like, we give a shit about efficiency in this country. Yeah. Like, no. Fat, lazy Americans.
No, this was after scanning for fucking 3 minutes trying to see if there was anybody working a register. I got to go to the fucking self-checkout with a mile long line.
We're about to have 5 memberships. Right? Like,
they're about to have... People are just going to start bum-rushing the self-checkout.
I'm not paying extra money to work a self-checkout. No. I'm already doing the work.
The audacity that you have to make me pay and I got to do all the work. Where do you get off? Where the fuck do you get off making me pay $65? I got to scan all the shit myself. And you give me no bags in the state of Vermont because we can't have plastic. So now I'm fucking, I got to put all the shit back in the cart. It's so miserable.
I wasn't using the self-checkout for convenience.
What are you guys doing?
Fuck my life.
Do you remember Bermuda shorts? Oh, you've seen them. I know you have, because if you've been to a Walmart, they are a fashion statement. It's those fucking, they cut like their pants and they stop right at about the calf. They're longer than a short.
Oh, you called it, what did you call
Bermuda?
It?
Bermuda shorts.
Oh, I call them capri pants. Remember back in the day?
Yeah, I have heard capri pants now that you say that.
Capri pants, that was like, it's a big time Euro thing, right?
I'll tell you what, it's not. That's a terrible engineer's design. It's just like, I want it a little bit longer than the short, but I'm going to get a little hot right about the calf.
Yeah, I think it was more of a fashion thing than it was like a practicality thing. Right?
What do they do with those denim pants with that much fucking slack left?
I'd rather go with the high sock. So, like, I'd rather go normal size shorts and then give me the 3/4 sock rather than go.
Oh, give we me know the your 3/4
pants.
We know your style. You jack those socks past your calf.
I get them right about mid calf. Right?
Yeah, we
you
know.
Don't want them to come up over the whole calf.
You got about
right. Yeah.
You have about 4 inches of skin showing in the sun.
That's what I'm saying. I got a nice band right around my knee.
You pull those socks so high up off your calves. It almost looks like, what are those fat guys that have to wear like the compression pants because of the blood clots?
That's exactly what I do. My style is like the 65-year-old guy living in Florida. That's my style.
You know what I saw? It's so bad. It was a fat chick wearing an I can't breathe shirt. The guy goes, yeah, no duh.
Joke hits on like multiple fronts.
Oh god, it's so bad. But that was just, this girl had the biggest fupa in the entire world and it just said I can't breathe. And the internet took to a liking.
Let me tell you something about the internet. You don't want to go up against the internet. That is a sea of just vipers.
A relentless, it doesn't quit.
A relentless ocean of hate.
It just continues to just come in. Like, you can't even, like, if I ever make...
It's an absolute machine of diarrhea. Just like a 50 caliber diarrhea machine, just
like when we make it, like I can't even go on the internet anymore, which is great because I'm actually looking for a reason not to ever go on the internet anymore because I fucking hate technology.
Yeah, and like I just don't give a shit. Like people could say the worst things about me on the fucking line, and I don't care.
Nothing's gonna really make me flinch at this point in my life. Okay, I've been said,
buddy.
I've had everything said to me.
I had about 10 to 15 youth hockey coaches growing up who told me I was the worst human being
psychopath.
To my face at fucking 11 years old. Okay,
oh, yeah.
So I'm pretty sure Bob from Wisconsin isn't going to rattle my cage.
Yeah, that and getting in trouble. Yeah, that and getting in trouble. Look at me. Never got grounded. Been arrested.
It just baffles me to this day how people can like get upset about things being said online when it's just like
half of them are robots anyways. Like, who gives a shit?
That's what I'm saying. It's like half of them are like bot accounts that people don't even really use. They just use to like talk shit. Like,
I just, the fact that some of these celebrities you hear about being like, I don't like what people are saying about me. It's like, dude, you live in a mansion. Just hang out there. Who gives a fuck?
Look, I don't know what it's like to have like millions of people say they hate me all at one time. So like, I can't necessarily say how that would feel for me because I haven't had that happen.
Yeah.
But I just like, I don't know. Like, I don't give a shit. Like, you can tell me I'm not funny. You can tell me I'm stupid. I'm retarded.
I was in the slow classes in fucking elementary school. You're going to talk about torture.
Family members, right? Like, I don't know. Yeah. Like, it's just, I think too, like when you grow up playing sports and like shit talking in sports, you sort of get callous to people saying bad things.
Doesn't bother you.
Yeah. You just get callous to it because it's like the fifth guy who's told you he's going to fuck your mom. You're kind of just like, yeah, okay. Guy, like I've heard it 50 times. Like, okay, you're like, all
right. You and the other guy.
Yeah, you and the 50 other people this season who've told me to pick up.
Come up with something different here.
Okay, like, all right, yeah. I don't know. It's just like the stinginess of it kind of doesn't, I don't know.
No, it's just pointless. It's so stupid that these people take it to heart. It's like, dude, who gives a shit?
People like, get rattled. Online. Oh,
and celebrities.
Celebrities.
Like, those people would be the most, like, they'd be kind of the most ability to, like, handle that sort of shit. Not at all.
I'm surprised at people's inability to handle the garbage. I'm still, to this day, it still surprises me when someone gets rattled about something online.
Oh, my God. I'm like, I was in the slow classes in fucking middle school. Those kids are ruthless to you when you're in that class by yourself.
You got somebody out there who's like trying to slander your name and call it. I don't know. I guess it just depends on what's happening. But if people are just generally telling you you suck, if it's just like generalness.
I could give a shit. Great. Great. I'll go back to Vermont.
I've had zero fans my entire life. I do not give a shit.
Great. I don't give a shit about you, too. I'm going back to Vermont. Fuck you. Fuck all of you. Can't wait to go back to Vermont. You can all blow me.
That's what she said.
Michael, we got some sports. Oh,
we have a big, big week. Sports-wise, just in general, what's happening, not necessarily that whole riot shit, but other stuff that's much more
F1 lighter. Miami.
Oh, really?
F1 Miami this week.
Really? We got the Kentucky Derby this week, too. How you darn?
Kentucky Derby this weekend?
First Saturday.
It's this Saturday? Oh,
First Saturday in May, baby. The Kentucky Derby.
They're off in the Kentucky Derby.
We got to look up the fucking horses and pick one.
I mean, I'm more of a spectator myself. I have no idea how to horse race. I like to watch the degenerate gamblers fucking hover around the tee.
Yeah, right? Like the big hat.
Have you ever been to the Travers?
I think I've ever been to Kentucky.
No, but yeah, I'll give you a little beautiful spot in upstate New York, Saratoga.
Oh, I've heard of it. Oh, I've been to a Saratoga.
Oh, baby. Okay. It's the Kentucky Derby of the Northeast.
Kentucky Derby of the North.
That place is. electric. The Traverse is so much fun. BYOB, how are you?
BYOP, bring your own party.
Bring your own party. Bring your own beach lawn chairs.
Yeah. Not quite the same outfits.
Oh, you got some people dress up. But then you got the dress up. You got a lot of
variety.
It's a great mix of dirt poor and super rich.
It's a great blending of the super rich
of classes.
The degenerate gambler
meeting. You know when like two different oceans meet and you can see the line? That's like the exactly rich meeting the poor. You have the people that own the horses, and then you have the guy who just bet his whole life savings on the said horse.
On the horse. Man, we gotta go to some races.
Oh baby, I would go back to the Traverse in a heartbeat. I love that place.
Hey, son.
Let's talk about the 2024 NFL Draft.
Okay.
Thoughts. Takeaways, how you feel about the Patriots?
Yeah, I feel great about it, except for the first pick.
Yeah.
I thought the first pick
sucks.
Was a tragedy, and then everything after that was okay. But, like, I get it. If you think that's the guy, then okay. My biggest thing is this.
He's not the guy. And you're fucking wrong. That's my biggest thing.
I hate to talk shit about somebody who, like, you don't know what's going to happen, but. But my take was this. The kid played at UNC, okay? And UNC is a great school. But in terms of football, okay, they hadn't played in any, like,
huge
games, right? Or games that had, like, very, very strong meaning, okay? So you got other guys like Penix and Bo Nix, these guys who are older, who have been in college football a lot longer because of that silly COVID year kind of like stuttered them.
Played in big games.
They've played in the biggest games. JJ McCarthy, you could have had. They've played in the biggest games with all the pressure for many years. So I get it. I get it. Like, you thought that was your guy. Okay. But, like, I'm just an odds guy. If
blows my mind.
Yeah, I'm not going to gamble. I'm always going to be the casino. I'm going to be the house, right?
Watching Bill Belichick break down that pick says it all.
And then Bill Belichick stomped all over the kid.
Just ripped the heart out of Pat's Nation.
Just like,
see ya. Held it right here and just.
Basically said everything I just said.
Yeah,
right?
Moves his feet. Doesn't have enough.
More things like footwork and some other shit he does bad.
Oh, yeah. Doesn't set his feet. He's like, every guy's like 8 yards away from their DBs. He's like, that never happens in the NFL. And then on top of that, he just makes some terrible decisions. Like, there's like wide open guys that he'll miss.
Look, I'm not going to burn
very
the coach.
Experience.
Yeah, I'm not going to burn the coaching staff quite yet, okay? Because of two things. One, we don't know how this kid's going to pan out. He could turn out to be a superstar. So there's that. And then the other thing, too, is like, how many of these
he's a superstar, I'll get that White Castle tattoo.
Yeah, and how many of these fucking draft picks in the last 19 years has Bill picked some fucking Division III kid from fucking University of Poster State that no one's ever heard of, right? That didn't pan out at all. And he was using, like, third and fourth round picks for. So, like, I'm not going to burn the guys just yet. Like, hey, let's see. Let's see. Maybe it pans out. Maybe the kid's a stud. You never know.
Yeah, I don't think so. But you know who will play over him? Joe Milton. How you doing? I love that.
How you doing,
pick.
Joe Milton? Yeah, so love I think that's going to be a lot closer of a camp than people think it is.
I think he plays before Drake.
I know that the guy can throw a fucking golf ball like,
A mile at 100 miles an hour.
Yeah.
So, he's got Randy Johnson speed with fucking Patrick Mahomes cannonball of an arm.
Legitimate howitzer cannon for an arm. 50 caliber how you doing, 1 mile sniper shot.
If Randy Johnson threw 100 yards at 100 miles an hour, that's big on Joe Milton's arm.
I'm big on him. So,
and you never know. I'm excited. So last year, he had no one. I'm excited
for the first time in a while.
Yeah, right. It was actually kind of nice when we drafted players you knew.
And, like, you know, you never want to see a guy like Bill go. He's a legend and whatever. But, like, okay, it happened. But and now I'm excited to just see, like, something new. See what happens, you know?
Yeah, I can't wait for Joe Milton to start.
Yeah. Probably.
Fuck you, right? Drake, man. First ticket out of here. I will show you no remorse.
I don't want to be the show that drowns Drake Maine before it's time yet. Let's just see what he does. I'll drown him. On draft day, I was like swearing his name up and down. So let's just see.
And he's probably an awesome guy. He looks like an awesome guy, which sucks.
I'm sure he's a great That's my go-to. I'm sure he's a great person.
Let me just chop him down real quick after. You build him up. Guy is an amazing human being off the field.
Comes from a great family.
Yeah, great family. Love his brothers. Love the story. Love everything about it. Join the brotherhood. Not gonna see that second contract.
Not gonna see one day on a NFL field.
If you had to guess, out of the three quarterbacks that were drafted, who is gonna be a bust? Out of the first three quarterbacks taken, who's gonna be a bust and who's gonna actually play?
Yeah, Drake May.
Bust. Who else?
Like, I can't tell if these two fucking guys hate me or they like me.
They keep saying how much they love me and they're shitting on me.
Shitting on me, but they're saying nice things about me. I don't quite understand what's happening here. I'm
confused. My prediction, Caleb Williams, so-so. Jane Daniels, bust. Drake May. Bust.
Really?
Yeah.
I'm going to say Caleb Williams, great. I'm going to say Jaden Daniels, so-so in Washington, because they got way more of a rebuild. And I'm going to say Drake Maine, bust.
I like it.
Because the thing is Chicago's got some pieces.
Yeah, he's got a lot of weapons around him. He'll be fine.
They got some pieces over there, right. And they got a defense.
Once they study that game tape of Caleb Williams, it's over.
I know, but
he'll be the Baker Mayfield.
I don't think Caleb Williams is the weapon people are going to study. Meaning this, nobody is planning for Brock Purdy, but Brock Purdy is getting the ball to all those fucking guys.
Yeah.
So I think it's going to be the same thing. I don't think Caleb Williams is going to have to make all the plays in Chicago.
Oh.
I think he could be kind of like a Brock Purdy.
He's got 1,000 playmakers to fucking pass it to.
Yeah. If they can just get the offense going a little bit, get the playmakers going. Right, then it's not all on him to be superstar Caleb, you know?
Yeah, no.
I think people are going to start taking the San Francisco book a little bit more serious, because then they don't have to rely
down in Kansas.
Yeah, then they don't have to have a fucking Patrick Mahomes to do everything, you know?
See what Kansas City's doing? They're copying the Dolphins. They just got all the fastest receivers they could possibly grab.
Yeah, fast
that aren't on Miami, and they're basically just gonna run the same playbook that Miami does.
No, I'm excited. I'm excited for football. Football's in a great place.
Excited for NFL. I'm excited for NCAA football, the video game.
Oh
and
my god, I'm just gonna talk about that video game on the show.
Oh god, I'm so horny for it.
We've been talking about it. For 3 years. I think it was on,
I
like,
can't wait to
episode.
Start a dynasty with Colorado and just run the tables.
Oh my god, just run the tables.
You and me, Dion. High five, buddy.
I wonder what the NIL situation in the game will be.
That would be hilarious. How interesting. Fucking, I mean, there's no fucking salary cap, right? So just start.
That's what I mean. Like, if they do a superstar mode,
Mix right? it, and you play. Sprinkle a little GTA 5 vibes in there with the NIL.
That's what I'm saying. Like, are you going to be able to, like, make some deals and stuff, like, outside of football?
Got caught with hookers and blow, suspended 4 games. GTA edition. College football. Damn, this game's accurate. It's so realistic. Damn,
this game's tough. 5 games suspension.
Just like
fucking draft stock's about to drop.
It's got the Madden sort of feel for the football, and then as soon as you're done, you leave the arena. It's GTA. It's GTA. The minute
suspension.
It's GTA. The minute you leave the arena, just sets up. You're just driving in the car to Clampus.
Driving around. Getting
five. Five stars.
Beating up referees.
Beating up camp. Yeah, beating up referees and people on the campus.
Yeah. Beating up teachers. That'd be hilarious.
This game got really realistic.
Damn, this game got realistic. You fucking ragdoll like a science teacher.
Oh, yeah. Smashing you got the bat. You got the bat. Remember the bat from GTA? Just beat people up with?
Yeah.
Hiding bodies.
I love beating up these teachers. Damn.
The side
I'm not even playing games.
I'm not even playing the real game. I'm just playing the side tasks. just driving around, stabbing hookers.
Just stabbing security guards and beating up teachers. This game is awesome.
They really got it down.
They really got this game down.
They really nailed it.
They really nailed this. Paying off security guards so they don't fucking write you up for tickets.
Driving at 100 miles an hour through a school zone.
Yeah.
Speaking of video games, did you see Dave & Buster's? You can now bet on the arcade games.
What?
Oh, you didn't see this?
You can bet on the arcade games?
Yeah, so you can live gamble.
On who's going to win the game, like the fucking game in front.
So think of all the arcade games, but then you just attach the casino aspect to it. You know, like you just put your money in, start betting.
So I don't understand what you're betting on.
The game, your ability to, whatever game you picked, see how well you do.
Okay, so like
you would earn tickets, but instead you're getting cash.
Oh, that's interesting. So, like, I go up to, like, a basketball shooting game, and I bet that I can hit 10 balls in 1 minute, and the machine's saying I can't. So then I play the game, and if
it's not
going to
give you lines. It's not going to give you lines.
If I get 10 balls in 1 minute, I get money back?
Yeah, it's kind of like, you know how you get tickets from, like, skee ball, but now it's cash.
Interesting.
So, betting on professional sports has ballooned into a multi-billion-dollar industry. Hold on. Let me read you the actual thing. A software company announced it teamed up with the arcade and restaurant chain to allow betting. The restaurant arcade chain Dave & Buster's is going to let customers bet on arcade games. Customers will be able to digitally place cash bets at the arcade where people play games like skee ball, billiards, basketball shots.
You know what this sounds a lot like, Sam?
Yeah, Always Sunny?
Sounds a lot like Patty's Dollars.
They will, because we'll redistribute these to the shanties, thus ensuring them coming back in, keeping the money moving.
Well, no, but if keeping the money moving.
Yeah,
how does this work, Matt? I don't know. I
blacked out. A technology company, Lacora, is teaming up with Dave & Buster's to provide digital betting service. So the company's product will be used for skill-based games at Dave & Buster's, including recreational activity for which the outcome is largely or entirely depending on knowledge, ability, strength, speed, endurance, intelligence. Of the participants and the subject to control those participants.
Nice. All right.
So they said that 18 and old. Yeah, so you got to be 18 and older.
Obviously.
It allows its partners to Customers can set limits based on their needs and preferences. Our typical average contest size is around $5 to $10. My God. It's going to be pretty fucking sweet. If two people are competing against one another in skee ball, presuming that there is nothing unusual done in the skee ball game and physical skills is actually going to determine the winner, there is no problem.
Let's I think I gotta see it live, you know.
Oh, if I can play skee ball, I will quit my job tomorrow.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, fuck.
Be heading to Dave and Buster's. I'm gonna be making a lot of money off of skee ball.
You're leaving the company to play skee ball.
Yes.
Yeah, full time. And I'm winning full time. Full time. I'll dash her over there to the old skee ball machine. Pick up lunch.
Pick up lunch. Maybe make $100.
Make a hundo, pay for lunch.
Hundo, free food. I'll be back in an hour.
I'll be back in an hour. I'll clean her up.
All right, this is the Price is Right ticket game where Sam tries to guess the ticket cost for live sporting events that are happening currently in your neighborhood. so there's these two major ones that we've been tracking. One of them has gone up and one of them has gone down. Really, really surprised about this.
I bet McGregor went down.
Which one do you want to do first? The one that went up or the one that went down?
Went down. McGregor.
No. The Jake Paul Mike Tyson fight has tickets have gone down.
Trying to finish up those seats. So I bet it's probably $356.
Nope. $393. Pretty close, yeah, though.
That was close.
Yeah, you're really close. Yep. And then the UFC 303 Conor McGregor return last week. This has only been 1 week because I checked the tape like when we did it last week.
Yeah.
Last week, the Conor McGregor fight was $1,193. Okay.
Yeah.
It's since gone up in price. What do you think that price is going to be? I can't believe it's still going up this much.
$1,450.
Holy shit. $1,455. That's crazy. You got it again.
I got it again. That's a sign, baby. Oh, McGregor. My God, that's a thank sign. You.
Maybe we should go.
Maybe we should shell out the $1,450.
$1,500.
Connor?
Let me tell you right now, I don't have the $1,500 to pay for the nosebleeds. You currently. At least,
that's nosebleeds for $1,500?
Nosebleeds, $1,455. That's the cheapest ticket you can get, $1,455.
Jesus. Nose beers, $1,400. Hey, how are you? How about you stop dicking us around and give us some fucking ringside
tickets? Hey, Dana. You got any of them free tickies?
How about you stop dicking us around, give
why
us some
you stop us
give us some fucking free ringside tickets.
Give us some ringside now, tickets here,
you're gonna sit down and you're gonna write Jesse and I an apology. You're and give us two tickets.
And you're gonna write us a check for Steve's Worldwide. I'm wearing the shirt.
Oh shit. What are the odds?
You're gonna sit down right now.
And you're gonna write Jesse and I two tickets. Ringside, no questions asked.
Ringside McGregor.
And you're paying for our flights.
Right here.
Imagine if this came across his desk.
Oh, fuck my him. God.
Get him the
we
tickets.
Have, like, two listeners. And I don't of, think yeah. one of them is Dana White. That would be fucking hilarious.
Two listeners. One of them's Dana White.
One of them happens to be Dana White. Oh, that's interesting. Okay.
The other, I think a pedophile, but we're not sure.
Some guy in China.
Some dude who just keeps DMing me. Yeah, some kid from Malaysia who keeps asking me if I want to buy shit.
Yeah.
And then Dana White. And Dana White.
Yeah. Those are our two viewers every week. Oh, my God.
Some dude in Thailand and Dana
White.
So, yeah,
White. That fight, how about that fight's gone up like $300 in a week.
How about, I got an event you should check out. How about this one? The Cost City Chili Peppers. It's a college baseball team for the summer league, right?
Okay.
Follow me?
Yeah.
They're going to host the first ever black light baseball game.
We need to hit it as high as we can and see if it loses sight
of cosmic baseball.
When you look dead on, you can see how bright it is.
So the jerseys are going to be glow-in-the-dark, the balls glow-in-the-dark, bats glow-in-the-dark, tire fields pitch black.
That's going to be crazy hard for the outfield.
Yeah, but it's black lights. So instead of using the normal lights that they did, they replaced them with black lights. That whole bitch is
going to be fucking... but I still think tracking that yellow ball is going to be more difficult than you think.
Probably. I mean... how about a fucking 99 mile an hour pitch glow in the dark ball? how are you, chin music?
How are you, 90 miles an hour?
So we had zero hits in 9 innings, and the fans got a little upset.
And the fans started to leave because they couldn't see
it. You know what? Halfway through that, it made more sense that that's why you play the game in the sunlight.
Yeah.
But the logo from the video looks kind of sick, though. Looks like a laser tag stadium.
Yeah. No, I got to check it out.
I'm excited.
And now for something completely different.
Also, did you hear about Chipotle? They're having a little crisis on their hands. They're running out of chicken.
Really?
Yeah, they're in a... so they've asked their employees not to put any chicken in their meals for their, like, their...
employee meals?
Yeah.
Why?
I guess they just, there's been such a huge surge with people wanting chicken that their supplier's been struggling to get it to them. But they said it's just a minor little hiccup. They'll be back to normal in a couple weeks.
That's interesting.
God bless those people who order chicken.
Right?
And have to get thrown food at their face. For a cause that they don't want to be fucking dealing with.
Absolutely.
Sir, okay. I don't care. You can stop yelling at me.
You can stop yelling at me, sir.
I just want to do this job. Oh, another sports thing. I forgot to tell you.
Yeah.
Have you ever seen professional air hockey?
I don't believe in defense.
What's defense, Bet?
Yeah. Here's that cut.
Professional air hockey? Yes. Holy I have.
Shit. Holy shit.
There was a clip of a guy getting hit in the nuts that I reposted, that I reposted on the Hyenas that got like 700,000 views. Like fucking outrageous amount of views. I think it's still on Local Big Time Instagram.
I gotta check this out because these people are fucking nuts. They fire that thing at about 100 miles an hour.
Oh my God, I've never seen that thing go so fast. And I thought like, I hit it hard.
I thought I hit it hard, and fucking, I can't believe the guy got hit in the nuts. All I kept thinking about is the knuckles. You know when you eat it right on the knuckles when that fucking thing comes up?
These dudes That's are the not most playing around.
Painful experience you could have when that puck hits your hand.
Fun child's game.
This guy was cradling it, and then he just snapped it as hard as he could with his wrist. The thing was like 100 miles an hour.
Yeah, and the other thing I'm really impressed at is the speed of the defense. Meaning, like,
how do you see it? You're just guessing.
They
right?
understand. They understand the angles so well that they only have to move the dial like a little bit right or a little bit left to know that the puck will bounce a certain way off it. Yeah. Right. So not even like they're not even chasing the puck around. It's just like they're moving right it here. A little bit right, little bit left, just, like this. Yeah.
Right here, just right in the steering lane.
Just keeping it right, 10 to 2.
Yeah. Safe. Safe. Yeah.
Safe. No, they understand, like, the radius of like, you know?
I just couldn't believe it. And then the celly that this guy gave was so over the top.
The pro guys they take it to a place I've never seen.
It was more than any NHLers ever celebrated. The guy was like, yes, yes. He's like slams the thing down. He starts screaming.
Oh, it's for real for them.
This is not a game. This is life or death. People's lives are at stake. Imagine being a fucking air hockey hustler, like you know, there's pool gamblers. Now there's air hockey gamblers.
I don't think you have much clientele for like betting, you know.
How about that?
Like,
oh, they're about to. Hello, Dave and Buster's.
Yeah, yes.
Now Dave their life has purpose.
I'm gonna go down to Dave and Buster's and be a hustler for fucking table hockey.
Just ringing up little kids.
Just absolutely taking little kids' money. Sorry, bud. $5.
Sorry, let's bud. Go. $5. Let's go.
Hit the road.
Next lesson. Put her in the bucket. You just got your food over you. You got your food. Get that giant basket over your shoulder at the table with all your stuff. You just throw the money over there, kid. You just set up shop next to a table.
Yeah. Give me another fry basket. Let's go.
Fry baskets, standing bar table right next to your air hockey.
Let's go.
Sorry, bud. Put a five in the bucket.
Sorry, pal. Hit the road. Come back and you don't suck so bad.
You know, it's cheaper to buy the bottle. Yeah, don't tell me what to do.
It's a free table, pal. Take a hike. You want to be the champ? You got to beat the champ. Okay, pal. Take a walk.
Will you let some of the kids use the table?
You want to run the table, pal? You got to beat the king first.
You got to play me for it.
You got to beat the king, pal. Otherwise, you can walk on down to the fucking kiddie table.
Hey, listen, I love what you're doing here. My kids were wondering if they could just play each other.
Not a chance, lady. Beat it.
You know,
trying
the
to make a living over here. All right. You can huck your ass on down to the fucking ski ball. All right.
Tell him to work a little harder, then he'll be able to play next time.
Air hockey's down there, pal.
Ski ball down there. I gotta make a living. I got a mouth to feed.
Trying to make a living over here, okay? So you can walk your ass on down to the fucking. Down to the fucking claw, okay?
Why don't you try your hand at the fucking light that goes in a circle?
Yeah, why don't you try your hand at the claw game, alright?
Beat it, beat it, bud.
Beat it.
You've been coming in here for like 90 days straight.
Just hustling people in air hockey. It's so stupid. Just an air hockey hustler. Taking kids' money. Sir, we have to ask you to leave.
You've been coming here America. For like the last 80 days. We're not, people have been saying some things.
We've had a few complaints about you and the air hockey table.
About you holding up the air hockey table.
What? Nobody can beat me? What's the complaint? Too awesome?
What's the lie, Brooke? Being too good?
Yeah. Handing out free lessons?
Handing out losses?
Buddy, I've been sending out messages all morning. All
right. Listen, the only assault that's taken place at this Dave and Buster's is the old ass whooping.
It's me. assaulting them on this table.
It's the ass whooping I'm handing out over there.
Is the ass whoopings I've been handing out to all these third graders for each to learn a life lesson.
There will be no participation trophies here.
Hey, buddy, I got a free 10 minutes of therapy for you. You suck.
Beat it.
Life's unfair. Beat it.
Life's unfair. Beat it.
There's your 10 minutes of therapy.
Yeah, well, you suck it more. Life's unfair.
Go cry to your mom and practice.
Yeah, well, you're a jerk off, too.
Yeah, maybe you didn't suck so bad. Maybe your kid didn't suck so bad, he wouldn't be crying.
Maybe it wasn't sucking the teat of spoilness, he'd be winning.
I thought this was America. Huh? Isn't this America? I'm sorry, I thought this was America.
All right. Couch Sesh, this Couch. Segment, the hottest new segment on the block, Couch Sesh, where Jesse and I bring you TV shows and movies you must watch.
Absolutely.
Hidden gems you probably never heard of. Maybe some you have. Who knows? But these ratings are as real as they come. I've watched a lot of people's movie reviews on TikTok to get suggestions. They suck. Their movies are so fucking bad. I got to do everything by myself.
I got to sit on this couch and slave away watching these shows for you.
I can't fucking copy anybody's work. I got to do everything by myself. But that being said, you're welcome. I have
that being said, you're welcome.
I've watched a lot of shit to give you fucking heaters, so you should be thankful, because this one, I almost didn't make the list, because I fucking watched like 10 shit shows just to get to some good ones.
Just to get to some classics.
Oh, yeah.
What
do you got? So, my first one, actually, you turned me on to this, and I watched it again. It popped up on my feed. The King of Collectibles.
The collectibles world can take you anywhere at the drop of a hat.
I've been in this business since I was a little kid, and I'm motivated by three things: competition, ego, and money.
My job is to work for you.
Rock, paper, scissors.
Ooh. People love doing business with me.
Streaming on Netflix. If you haven't watched this show, it's so fucking addicting. It's unbelievable. This guy just travels the country collecting comic books, action figures, playing cards, anything you can think of, you name it, he's probably collected it and then resold
everything
it for these people.
Cool and pop culture related. Like
the items that this guy finds, they had like the first ever Mac in one episode. It was crazy.
Oh, yeah. For that episode, yeah. Sick. No, I kind of like low key would, after, if we ever do shows and stuff, I would love to do that for my life. Once I'm like 80.
I would love to go on a show as one of his guests and do the auction. You know how he'll have a guest celebrity for the auction? Mm-hmm. Come on. You could have two for one, buddy.
We don't really fit in the celebrity category. We're more in like the basement of the internet, but yeah.
Still, it's somewhere.
We'll be entertaining.
We will crush it. And it got me into cards. Like, just watching these people collect cards is,
I know, it's cool, right?
Crazy how much some of the stuff's worth. It's incredible.
Oh my god, I was just going through my cards and I found what I found, I think. Hold on. My basketball cards.
All right, but so my Couch Sesh, if you haven't, streaming Netflix, King of Collectibles, must watch. Jesse actually turned me on to it.
Yeah, seen it, fucking loved it.
Unreal.
Loved it, probably watch it.
You'll crush all the episodes in one sitting. All you have to do is watch the first one, you'll be hooked.
You'll be hooked.
Can't wait for a season two. I don't know if there is one coming out, but I hope so.
Yeah.
What Absolutely. Do you got for your Couch Sesh?
Okay, so my first Couch Sesh is there's a show called Trafficked on Hulu.
Should I be concerned about my security? This hasn't actually ever been filmed before.
Money is the root of all evil.
Oh, fuck yeah. I love this show.
Maria Zellner, I think her name is.
Awesome.
Yeah, and it's like a show where she goes into all of these like drug worlds and talks to all these people about how merchandise gets shipped like through different places.
Oh yeah.
So you can crush, there's three seasons on Hulu, you can crush them all like just sitting in the background during one
the
weekend.
Bounty Hunter or yeah, not the Bounty, the Hitman episode is crazy.
Yeah, and you're gonna Hitman. See Yeah, you're going to learn some shit that you had no idea was going on.
You're
going to
see some shit. You're going to learn some shit.
You're going to see some shit.
Hey, that's what she said.
For my next couch session, this is streaming on Peacock. The Office has come out with Super Fan Edition.
Lived on a kibbutz. Hmm. Wow. What's a kibbutz?
It's a farming community in Israel.
Did you grow beets?
No, mainly oranges.
Those are good, too. Uh-huh. You should write a book about your life. It would be a bestseller.
Wow.
Shut up, Jim. No one's talking to you, okay?
You are.
Shut up.
Mission episodes. Have you heard of this?
I have not. Super Fan Edition. I've heard of the extended episodes.
This is a complete... Like, I've seen every deleted scene on The Office...
Yeah.
This is, I don't even know where they had this extra material because it's like 15 extra minutes. And sometimes the extra material changes the scene completely. Like,
They're,
like for instance, the fun run, they're interviewing Michael. He's like, so, you know, right before they're about to take off, he gives a big speech.
Right.
So during that big speech, in that big speech, he goes, "All right, everyone, be sure to run on the sidewalk because we did not get permits to run on the street." And it just says he tried to rope off the street and cars are just driving through it.
Yeah.
But, like, it's hilarious. It's a must watch. It's changed my entire... Like, I love The Office. I've seen it, like, a billion times. This has given me new life. If you haven't checked it out, must watch. Peacock Super Fan Edition. You'll piss your pants. It'll make you laugh again.
Yeah.
Highly, highly, highly suggest it.
Huge. All right. My next couch sesh is on Amazon, and it is one of my all-time favorite movies. I've watched it about 9 quadrillion times. It's the movie Snatch.
I don't care if it's Muhammad, Imar, Bruce Lee.
You're going down in the fourth round.
Whoops.
Oh, with, great movie.
Yeah, with Brad Pitt and as the gypsy fighter and Guy Ritchie.
Crushes that scene.
Yeah, and Guy Ritchie is the, he wrote and directed, he's one of my favorite writer directors. You know, it's like
wrote and directed that.
England gangster movie, which I love. He also did Lock, Stock, and Two Smoking Barrels, Sherlock Holmes. He's done a lot of like fun, kind of gangster.
Sherlock Holmes with Robert Downey Jr.?
Yeah, he did that one too, yeah.
Oh, shit. That's incredible.
Yeah. So, no, and he's done a bunch, and he just did a movie that called The League of Extraordinary Gentlemen.
Oh, that's coming out, right?
Yeah, I saw it. Yeah, it was good.
How is it?
It was great. I thought it was great. Really excited about this. Saw this in the store today. Limited time only. Pringles Texas barbecue brisket.
Oh.
What is this
is correct.
Holy limited gosh. Time only Texas brisket.
Damn.
Texas barbecue brisket. Here we go.
Welcome to Texas. Okay.
Smells very barbecue-y.
I wonder if it'll be more barbecue-y than the barbecue Pringles.
I don't know. We're going to find out. I usually grab two to double up on flavor taste.
I actually grab two as well. I never grab a singular Pringle. I don't think anyone. If you do, you are a psycho or a serial killer.
Really good. You can really taste that, like, brisket, like, smoke flavor.
Now, is it more McRib or is it more actual brisket?
No, it's like definitely more brisket, more smoke. You know what I mean? Like smoky.
Have you ever had the barbecue sunflower seeds where it has that smoky taste?
Mm-hmm.
Like that?
Just like that. But also a little bit sweet from the barbecue. This is really good. I'm going to eat this whole thing tonight.
Imagine if they collabed with
9.7. This is so good, it should be a regular flavor.
Imagine if they collabed with, like, Sweet Baby Ray's.
You don't have to. That's what they got.
That's what I'm sitting on right now.
That's what I got in this can right here.
You sound like a Flex Seal ad.
Let me tell you how good these Pringles are. I'm going to build a whole boat out of these Pringles, and I'm going to drive it on the water. You got a hole in your wall? Let me just take one of these Pringles. Smash! No more hole.
That's what I got in this can. That's what I got in this can.
That's what I got in this can right here. $34.99. We get you one of these, and you know what? We're going to give you one for free.
You know what? We'll give you a backup because we know the first one's a piece of shit.
We're going to give you two.
For when the first one fails.
Like,
You call me pissed off. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to send you two more for free.
You don't like the original one we sent you? Guess what? I'm going to send you two more. No charge. For you.
I don't want your fucking product.
I don't want the fucking product.
I just want my money back. Listen, 30-day free trial.
Listen, you don't even have to worry about getting your money back. You know what I'm going to do here? I'm going to send you four cans. Four cans. Free charge. Right to your house.
That's $100 value. Four cans.
For free. Right to your house.
Right to your house.
That's what I'm going to do for you.
You better hang up now because I'll send you six. I'm just shipping.
You better hang up now because I'm about to double that order. I'm telling you right now, you better bring up that phone because I will double this order. I'll make it eight cans. Can we do it? All right.
Eight cans.
We're doing it. Eight cans.
You want to make it 16? You better hang up that phone right now. He just gets like 20 boxes outside his house.
I just want my money back for the original.
I just want my 50 bucks back.
Jerk off sent me 50 boxes full.
Not only does this not work, now I have 50 boxes of this shit not working.
Not only do I hate these Pringles, but now I'm going to sit on 50 boxes of these bullshit. Oh my god, that was so funny.
You better hang up right now.
Because I'll double it.
Yeah, most of the time we just hang up because we're done dealing with them.
Most of the time we just stay on the line to see how many orders they'll double. We're not going to buy it. see how many times they'll double it.
You're not getting your money back, but what you will get is about 16 free cases full of the play cards, right?
But they will send you a truckload of the shit. Yeah. Oh my god. All right. You got one?
Oh, yeah.
That's hilarious.
All right. For my snack lords, I'm throwing it to a classic. Twizzlers gummies.
Ooh, okay. So okay. Got... Twizzlers have a very distinct taste, so I'm curious if this will taste more Twizzler or more gummy.
I'm a little scared, you know. Right now, squeezing the bag, it feels like a gummy flavor, right? On the back, it says, try Twizzler gummy fruity flavor fusion with a twist. We got lemonade, cherry, peach and cherry, grape and cherry. Twizzlers. Like new gummies. How are ya?
Hey, now.
How you doing?
Right up the keister.
Yeah, seriously. Right up my keister is right. It's got the gummy feel. So it kind of feels like fruit snacks.
Okay.
Sort of feel on the texture. Let's see what we got here. Oh, that is a fruit snack. If I've ever seen one.
Okay.
That is the... What do we got here? That must be the lemonade cherry. Oh, my God. Wow.
Is it good?
These are weirdly really fucking good. Holy shit.
Nice.
I thought these were going to suck. No offense to Twizzler.
Yeah. Well, you're not in the gummies game, to be fair, Twizzler. You know? You're not really...
Well, when I first... Like... When I first heard gummy, I assumed they were just going to count the Twizzler candy as a gummy, you know?
Right.
And put like a little gummy tip on it.
Yeah.
Complete gummy. Not even a Twizzler. They just have the name.
I like it.
Unreal. Oh, my God. It's like those. Have you ever had those Lifesaver fruit snacks? You know, gummy ones?
That's my next one
right here.
Okay, nice.
Yeah, you might want to pair this with the movie suggestions we gave you.
Yeah.
9.2.
Oh, that's really high for you.
I'm surprised. I'm not a 9.2 guy.
No, you're not.
Living in a 9.2 world.
I'll roll that into my segue into my next one, which is Lifesavers Gummies Neons.
See, I love Lifesaver gummies.
I like
Never had a neon.
I've never had the neons.
Nope, neither have I. I'm excited. What do we got for flavors?
Bold Berry, Orange Pop, Pink Punch, Cherry Lime Splash, and Electric Lemonade.
Yeah, I don't think you're going to have one bad flavor out of that batch.
I think I'm going to have one bad experience here.
I still can't stop laughing over that fucking... You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to send you 16 cans.
No. I'm going to double
better,
it.
You better hang up right now, so I'm going to double it.
You better take this deal.
You know what? It's genius marketing.
Oh, yeah.
Hate the product. Send you more. If you love it, you have to pay.
These are unbelievable.
Really? Yeah, I had a feeling.
Oh, yeah. That lime one is my favorite.
Mm-hmm. Was that the lime electric or whatever?
Cherry lime splash.
Oh, God. Cherry lime is like the greatest flavor. Just drink beverage alone. Cherry lime's amazing.
Cherry lime is one of my favorite combo flavors going.
You ever had that Celsius cherry lime?
I'll eat anything cherry lime.
I'll eat a piece of shit with some cherry lime on it.
Cherry lime. I'll fucking crush anything cherry lime, yeah. I'm going to give these a 9.5 out of 10.
Would you sneak that in to the movie theater?
This?
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I could sneak this in 5 seconds. This isn't even this. This is like the start what I would sneak in.
Well, I know you've snuck in. You're a Trojan horse for sneaking in snacks, but I meant, would you?
Trojan horse for movie theater sneak in.
There was a time where there was a competition to see who could sneak in the most outlandish food. Jesse once had a box of pizza. Pizza.
Got a whole pie in there, but got a whole pie in that bad boy. Once just had to
whip it out.
Flip her horizontal for about 5 minutes and got it back up.
McDonald's, you name it. We also used to do the old matinee.
Snuck in sandwiches just recently. We snuck in all sorts of stuff.
Now, Steve once tried to sneak in chicken wings. I thought that was a terrible mistake. I don't care. Sneak it in? Absolutely. That's the worst thing you want to eat. Yeah, no napkins.
That's terrible movie theater food, chicken wings.
Thank you. Terrible etiquette, right? What are you going to do with your fingers? Just wipe them all over? You're going to be that huge asshole that just wipes your fingers on the seat cushion to the side?
It's not even that. It's just like it's a whole thing, and you don't have like a table or anything, you know? Like,
yeah, like boneless, maybe, you know? It's still messy as shit. Yeah, but okay. Like,
tenders.
He was going to do one thing. Bone in. Chicken. Like physical fucking bone in and just like.
Can't do it.
What are you going to do with your fucking hands?
Yeah. Too much.
Would you sneak that into a movie theater though?
No, not chicken wings.
No, I'm talking about your gummies.
Oh, yeah, the neon gummies, for sure. Yeah. Lifesaver gummies are unbelievable. That's one of my go-tos in the movie theater for gummies.
It is a great movie theater snack.
All right, and then I'll do my next one because I got so many. This one is Oreo limited edition. It's called the Dirt Cake Flavor.
I've walked by that. I've always wanted to try it.
Yeah, and there's sprinkles on the top.
Oh shit.
That are supposed to be like gummy worm sprinkles.
That's sick.
So I have no idea what this is gonna look like. Here we go.
I almost need a dry review and a milk review.
Oh yeah, I don't have any.
That's great.
Alright. Pull one out.
I love what Oreo's been doing with their flavors. They've just been letting it rip.
Oh, that's kind of cool. So there's like, I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. Oh,
I see it right there, right on the top.
Yeah.
Like infused on the Oreo cookie.
Yeah, like gummy worm sprinkles.
Gummy bits.
And then here's the best part, okay? So this is a double stuff.
Okay.
Half of it chocolate mousse, and half of it is chocolate cake. So look at this.
Oh shit! Look at that. See that. You got a dark chocolate and a light chocolate.
Yeah. So the snack that you make as a kid.
What am I gonna make? Like tiramisu.
It's not tiramisu. It's dirt cake.
No. But yeah, dirt cake like you had as a kid.
Yeah, like cake and then chocolate mousse and then cake and chocolate mousse, right? But the fact that it's a double stuff, that's great. You know.
They really. Got it down to a T. It's like,
here we go.
The authenticity is out of this world.
That's solid. What's really going to make these?
Milk.
That. And the fact that it's double stuff means that it's like perfectly balanced cookie, you know?
Yeah, you get a perfect 50-50.
Yeah. This is really good. It tastes just like chocolate pudding and chocolate cake mixed together, really.
How's the gummy worm? Can you taste the gummy worm?
Here's the thing. I'm an honest reviewer, okay? I love these on here, and they look cool, but you can't really taste them at all. Yeah. But they're really cool, and I like that they're on there. Yeah, I'm going to give this a 9.4. At 10.
Wow.
Solid. Very solid.
I like it.
Do you have one?
Oh, you betcha. Let me I love this company. And I really like their candies. I never get them all the time. But these are brand new. We got Laffy Taffy Fruit Combos. How are you?
How are you? I'm a huge Laffy Taffy guy.
Oh, I love, absolutely yeah. love Laffy Taffy. And love. The flavors look electric.
I would okay, love to get got... sponsored by Laffy Taffy. That oh would be like God,
a dream of ours. I think they're a Wonka company, right?
I think so.
I would love to be under the Wonka umbrella. I love all their candy.
Clearly, I wouldn't mind the fucking Wonka umbrella.
Judging from the hat, big Wonka fan. these flavors Wonka look fan. Out of this world. Strawberry kiwi, mango passion fruit, wild berry banana, strawberry orange. Two strawberries. That must be a good flavor then.
Here we go.
As you can tell, it is new. Here we go. Just dropped today. What do we got? Wow, holy shit. All these flavors smell amazing. Oh my God.
Individually wrapped?
Individually wrapped. I'm going to hit it up with... Uh-oh. And we're going to work our way through each one. Absolutely. Strawberry kiwi. How are you? We're going to eat our way through this.
We're going to eat our way through this bag. It's going to take me 20 minutes for each piece. It's like sandpaper.
Oh, shit.
It's going to take you like 20 years to chew through each one of those.
These things are impossible to get out of the wrapper. That's the only...
Just two colors. Just do one review and then review the others like in this like later in the week.
Dude, oh my God. Flavors are on point.
What is it?
That's strawberry kiwi.
Okay.
I want everything. Strawberry kiwi.
Strawberry kiwi is another great franchise combo. Yeah.
Can't go wrong. I've never been a bad strawberry kiwi.
Here's the thing. You may not love a strawberry kiwi, but you're always going to not like it. Right? So you're never going to hate it.
When you're at a grocery store... And you don't know any other drinks?
Yeah.
See the flavor strawberry kiwi? It's a safe pick.
Safe pick. Always a safe pick.
This is my other favorite I want to try. Wild berry banana.
Okay. Banana can go either way for me. You got to be careful with it.
I weirdly like Laffy Taffy's banana. As weird as it is. Wow, wild berry is unreal.
Yeah. I knew that wild berry was going to be good.
Oh, my God. Incredible. Banana Laffy Taffy tastes just like exactly what you think, the banana Laffy Taffy. All right. Last two here. Working our way through the bag.
Yeah.
What was that? Mango. Strawberry orange. Okay, strawberry orange. Pink and orange. How are you?
Strawberry orange, I like it. Orange is another one that can go either way.
Yeah, orange can flip on it. Really good orange. Can't taste a strawberry.
Okay.
That's going to be my number three. Could be number four, depending on how this guy goes. I can fucking peel it. Oh my God, that orange is delicious. All right. Last but not least.
Banana.
Mango.
Oh, mango.
Mango passion fruit.
Okay, so here's the thing. I fucking love mango as a flavor.
Oh, I love mango as a flavor.
I love wow. real mango.
Oh, wow. That passion fruit.
Yeah.
It's like that blindside hit on a kickoff.
Yeah.
Unreal.
That kickback wow. block.
Yeah, that kickback block. It's ill reversal. Wow. That's the number one. Two, strawberry. Wow. Two go either way. Wild berry's really good. Strawberry kiwi. Banana wild berry. Strawberry orange. That's nice. The rule. You'd smoke this bang in about 5 seconds. Give you 9-1.
Huge score. Huge. Big score. All right, my last one. Super excited about this guy. I've been crushing a lot of these lately. Red Bull, the new Sea Blue Juneberry.
Oh, you never had a Juneberry? I love Juneberries.
Really?
Have you seen the new one they came out with for this year?
That's for this
the summer?
One.
No, it's green.
Oh, yeah, I did it on last week's show.
A cilantro. What's that green one called? Culabra.
Yeah.
An Ellie flower.
Do you want to get flower. It? We'll do it for next week.
Fuck yeah. It's unreal.
All right. Here's the Juneberry. Sam likes it. I've never had it.
Juneberry is my favorite drink.
Oh, yeah. Mango pack. That's unbelievable. That's like a tart blueberry. That's unreal. Red Bull. You can send me 16 boxes of these.
Yeah, you can. I will not hang up the phone. You can keep sending them.
Yeah, you can send me.
You know what? Why don't you back that fucking Red Bull truck right up to our house?
Yeah, this is delicious. I could drink a million of these.
And I'm gonna.
9.9. And it goes with the color of our channel, blue.
That's right. Blue. Look at that, blue and blue.
1, 2, 3. How you doing?
Doing? Got a favorite color?
How are you,
blue?
Yeah.
Oh, all right, no, Toronto just scored 1-0.
This is game 6, right?
4 seconds left in the second.
I'm telling you, this is going to be a game 7 situation. These motherfuckers are going to do this shit again.
It's always like that. Nylander, my doppelganger.
Yeah.
Off a tip.
All right. Well, this was a good show.
Great, great episode. I'm still pissing my pants over the 60. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to double it. 16 coming your way.
Well, for all of us here at Channel 4 News, I'm Ron Burgundy. You stay classy, San Diego.
And thanks for stopping by.